Before getting started, we have something to do in our start command. If you had not already done this, you have to do it right now. Press start and R key together. And in run command, you have to type cmd. And you have to type pip space install space pygame. Now if you already have this installed, it won't install again, but if you are installing it for the first time, you have to wait for some time till it gets installed. Hello friends, we are back after a while, and from now onwards our videos will have a totally new approach. We will be working on innovative puzzles to solve our problems and to learn our concepts more efficiently. And to explain what I mean more deeply, from now onwards you will be downloading a specific folder, and it's like a package, and this package has animation contents and stuff, and you can use them to visualize our concepts. So okay, let's go into it. You have to go to this link, it will be given in the description below, and you have to download this folder, and I have it ready and I will save it. I'll save it to my desktop Python folder. I'll save it and I'll open that folder. Okay, now I'll extract it. Okay, this is no longer required. Okay, so now we have a folder called as images and we have a program called as steps.py. Now I have to create a new Python script. So I'll do it like this, loops.py. So okay, I'll break it here. Today's concept will be based on loops, so we'll be focusing on while loop and for loop. There are only two kinds of loop in Python, while and for. There's no do while loop in Python. So okay, now we'll create this script and we'll do it. So okay, what is this steps.py? Okay, now it is like a program, and it can be used like some kind of library. We can import the program into our current script. So I'll do it like this, import steps. So now by this statement I am just bringing all the functions inside the steps.py into my program. So I have two functions, initial and final. So before actually we are using this concept called as functions, even though we have not posted any videos on functions, but it's not a big deal. We'll see an even more detailed video on functions in later videos. So I'll just tell you how to use functions. So now we have two functions called as initial and final. And since these functions fall under this program, we have to call them like this, steps.initial and steps.final. Sorry. Okay. So now this initial is a function which returns a value to us. So now it's like, let us take x is equal to 5 plus 4. So now this 5 plus 4 is something like a function. It returns a value and we can store it in x. Similarly, steps.initial returns a list to us. So we'll have it like this, x is equal to steps.initial. So now this function returns a value to us and we store it in a variable. That is, we store the list inside the variable. And steps.final is another kind of function. And the difference is here, we send the value to the function and it takes the value from us and it processes the value. So we have to return another list to it. So we'll just send the same value back to it. I'll have a small delay here. So we'll input. Okay, so this is our program. We are calling a function and storing the value in a variable, and we are waiting before the user presses the enter key. So we will press the enter key and then this function will get executed. So okay, we'll run it. So now this is staircase, and now this is a jumbled staircase. So now if the player has to go here, the staircase should be in a sorted manner. So we'll have it as a list here. You can see it here, 1, 2, 3, 0, 4. So the proper order should be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So now if we send that list here, the proper list will be sent there. But currently we are only sending the same value back here, so there's no changes. So now we'll sort it using today's concept called as loops. So this is our problem statement. We'll come back to it after one or two videos, but this is what you have to have in your mind before watching the video further. Okay, so okay, now let us move on to today's concept called as while loop. Now I'll create another program here. Or wait, while open Python IDE. So okay, now what is the syntax? What is a loop actually? A loop is, you know, everyone knows what is a loop. It is a closed continuous figure, something like that. In Python, a loop is doing the same operations again and again. If you are well versed in C and C++, you already know what is a loop. So we are going to execute the same functions again and again. And for while loop, the syntax is like this. While, we'll have a conditional statement here. You know what is a conditional statement? It returns a true or false value. So we'll have a if x is greater than 5. So now this is our conditional statement. And before that, let us initialize x. Sorry, x is equal to 10. Okay, now while if x is greater than 5, like a if statement, we'll have a colon here and we'll have an indenting here. Invalid syntax, sorry. We'll just have a comparational statement here. X is greater than 5. Now we'll print x. And now the thing is, if the value is true, the loop will get executed. If the value is false, the loop will not get executed. So now x is greater than 5, so it will get executed again and again. How do we stop the loop? So we'll have something like this, x is equal to x minus 1. So with each loop, the x value gets decremented by one value and the value gets printed here. Okay, now let's try running the loop. So we have 10, 9, 8, 7, 6. 10 is greater than 5, so x got printed, x got decremented. 9 the same, 8, 7, 6. So now while we are in 6 got printed and x turned into 5. So now 5 is not greater than 5, so the loop got terminated. So now this is the while loop. We have a conditional statement, we have a comparational operator, true or false statement inside the loop, and as long as the value is true, the loop will get executed, and when it turns into false, the loop gets terminated. So now this is the while loop syntax. So we have another kind of loop. This is the infinite loop. So while true, so as the value inside it is true, it will get executed again and again and again. It will run infinitely. So I'll print x here. So now I'll try running this. So as you can see, since the value is true for all the loops, the loop will get executed infinitely. So we'll stop it using Control Z or Control C. So this is a keyboard interrupt to stop a faulty program. So now why do we have to use an infinite loop is, for real world applications, we have to perform the same execution, same operation again and again. We won't be knowing when to stop in a real world application. So we'll have something like a condition. When the condition is satisfied, we'll just break the loop using a break statement and a continue statement. So we'll see what that is. While true, so now this is an infinite statement, infinite loop statement. So we'll have we know x was 5, so we'll have print x, and x is equal to x plus 1. So now we'll have a conditional statement. If x is greater than 10, break. So the statement got so the loop will terminate itself when this condition is satisfied. So now let's try it. So though this was an infinite loop, it got terminated after finite iterations. An iteration is like one run of the code inside the loop. So 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. So 10 got printed and 10 is not greater than 10. So while x becomes 11, now so when x is 11, this condition will be true and the loop will be terminated. Though this is an infinite loop, since this condition got true and this break statement got executed, the loop will get terminated and we'll have only finite values printed here. So we have another statement called as a continue statement. So let's try what that is. So first we'll initialize x. X is equal to 0. While x is lesser than 10, x double equal to 3. Continue. X is equal to 3. X is equal to x plus 1. So when x is equal to 3, the continue statement will get executed, and if not, the print statement will get executed. So actually we'll see why, what is the use of continue. So now initially x will be 0 and x will be incremented that one. So now as long as this condition is true, the loop will get executed. So initially x will take the value 0 plus 1, which is 1. So 1 is not equal to 3, so this continue statement won't be executed and print x will be executed. So the loop will iterate and when finally x will become 3. So if x is equal to 3, this statement will be executed. So what the statement does is, if this statement got executed, the lines following the statement won't be executed. That is, if this is true, x won't be printed. So it will move on to the next iteration. So x will become 4 and x won't be 4. So x will not be equal to 3. So the statement will not get executed. So now let us see what I'm trying to say. So as you can see here, 1 got printed here, 2 got printed here, but 3 was not printed here. So we have 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. It is because 3 is equal to 3. So continue statement got executed and all the lines succeeding this continue statement will not be executed if this was executed. So now that is break and continue. So now let us try a small activity. We'll have a create a small list called as S list. S list is equal to Kishore, Kumar, Mitra, Robotics, Tutorials. Okay, now we have a list. Now we'll have a loop while okay, first we'll initialize x. X is equal to 0 while x is greater than x is lesser than length of s list. So what I'm trying to do here is, this is a list, it has 5 elements here. So length of x will be 5. So as long as x is lesser than 5, the loop will get executed and we'll do something like this. So print s list of x. So now I'll run it. Okay, sorry. We'll have while x is lesser than length of s list, print s list of x and x is equal to x plus 1. So now this was what I missed in previous this error statement. So now we'll have to increment x with each iteration. So now that is one of the disadvantages of while loop. So okay, let us see it. So Kishore Kumar Mitra Robotics tutorials. So each of the element inside a list got executed sequentially and it was printed on the screen. So x is equal to x plus 1, and these are the statements which are required to do that. We can even do these things in a very even more simpler manner in a concept called as for loops. We'll see that in our next video. So thank you for watching. If you have any doubts, leave a comment in the comment section. Thank you for watching. Bye.